Well, hello, beautiful people. Welcome back. Welcome to my February month end favorites, which, if I do say so myself, this was the fastest month in all of history, just saying. But nonetheless, guys, we're here to sit down, talk about some things I've been loving this month. I've got some new makeup. I have actually some old makeup that kind of resurfaced that I'm obsessed with. I've got this hair tool situation. I've got a serum. Now, before we get going into all of that, I actually want to pause and talk about Billy, because Billy is partnering with me on today's video. And y'all, I am so next level excited for this. And thank you to the people. Actually, not even just thank you for me, okay? Thank you to Billy from me and my smooth ass legs for designing this fantastic freaking razor. If you guys don't know who Billy is, let me explain, okay? Billy is a female first body brand, and they actually wanted to create products, like high quality, good body products that women could buy that were affordable, that didn't have the pink tax. Which, by the way, if you don't know what the pink tax is, get ready to be irate, okay? Because the pink tax is quite literally the extra money that you are charged just for purchasing a product that is targeted or designed for a female. So not only do you not have to pay this ridiculous pink tax, or also the insane prices for stuff like this that already exist at the store, which I know I have ranted about so many times on Instagram, but y'all, I just think the pricing for, it's insane to me. Like, why? And it's not even a tailored process for me. Like, hello, you're gonna charge me a pink tax for being a girl, but you're not gonna actually give me something that's literally created for me? I don't think so. But with Billy, all of that's taken care of, because the starter kit is $9 freaking, you guys. $9, free shipping. And in there, you actually get the handle, you get 2 blade refills, and you get the little magnetic thing that goes in your shower, which actually, I have an overlay, and I'm gonna put it up right now, because y'all, I am freaking in love with this little magnetic holder, because I hate having to have my razor just like down over here on this shelf. Is it upside down? Is it right side down? Is it gonna fall? Am I gonna step on it? Like, it drives me crazy to have that thing just always floating around my shower. Also, not only is it $9 and it comes with the magnet and the 2 refills and the handle, but it also comes in 5 different colors, and I am freaking upset. Like, look, my nails, this was not on purpose, okay? I just love this color so much. Also, by the way, while we're on this $9 topic of conversation, not only is their starter kit $9, but all of their little refill packs are $9 as well, which are 4 of their little blade refills here, and you can choose, okay? This isn't one of those companies that want you to make sure that you're getting it once a month, even if you're not gonna use it. You get to set your own time frame for how much you shave and what your own personal self-care looks like for you. And also too, I was gonna say this is random, but it's not, because we're talking about a razor, but we're gonna talk about my leg hair for just a second. They did not tell me to say this, but I just need to tell you that my leg hair, okay? If you're out there and you're like, oh, as a female, like, I think that my leg hair is too coarse, or what? No, okay, you don't even know what coarse is, okay? I have sticks that grow out of my, like, it actually feels like little stick-like, hey, tentacles just pushing out of my leg, and it drives me insane, okay? Like, I'm one of those people, again, doesn't matter when you shave, I like to shave often because I can't stand that texture, and I loved that with them, the shave, so close, so smooth, so wonderful. And by the way, I'm not talking about that fake little moment when you're, like, in the shower and you're going, oh, it's smooth. Yeah, well, of course your leg is smooth in the shower, but what about when you get out of the shower, okay? The wind hits you and poof, your leg hair starts to grow, okay? Is your leg still smooth? Because, bitch, mine is. But really what I wanted to say here was twofold, okay? Number one, I just wanted everyone to know that I shaved my legs. Thank you so much. They are wonderful. And they feel amazing, okay? These fluorescent ass white honey hams here, they are feeling smooth. Okay, number one, thank you. And then, of course, number two, if you want to take a look at Billy, if you want to take a look at the $9, okay, the $9 subscription service with free shipping, make sure you check out down below. I will have everything linked for you. And again, thank you so, so much to Billy for partnering with me on this video. Guys, I'm over the moon for this. I hope you guys like it. I hope you check it out. And with that, let's go ahead. I'm gonna grab a little drink because I am so thirsty. And we're gonna get into this video, but bitch, I need, see, I'm sorry, let's pause. Diet Coke. Diet Coke with light ice. All right, so now moving into some of my other favorites for the month, you guys. First thing I want to talk about is actually my new attachment for my Dyson Airwrap. This is a game changer. It is a longer barrel. And by the way, if you don't know what a Dyson Airwrap is, I will have it linked down below. I think that it is one of the, it is the best hairstyling tool that I have ever purchased, hands down. And yes, when you look at the price, you will, you know, choke a little bit, I'll admit it. But it is so unbelievably worth the money. Like, I can't even, if I could only have one hairstyling tool for the rest of time, it would be my Dyson Airwrap. That is how much I love it. And by the way, that is someone, I wear my hair straight, I wear it wavy, I wear it all kinds of different ways. And I think that the Dyson Airwrap is so, so worth the money. But that's besides the point. Because for today, I wanna talk specifically about this new longer barreled attachment for it, which, just for comparison here, and I actually have a little video, which I'll throw up right here. This is the original barrel, the one that it comes with. And the problem, if you have longer hair like me, or, you know, even longer, of course, course. The problem is that it's really hard to get, you know, a nice amount of your hair around this. You have to section off smaller. And then a lot of times you end up not being able to get the entirety of your hair wrapped around it. Whereas with this new long little beefy ass attachment, okay, look at all that extra space. Look at all the room for activities, you guys. This thing is wonderful. There's something about, like, not only how much room it is because your hair can spread out farther, but also the increased length makes it so you can grab slightly larger sections. So having this, not only do I get like a bigger, longer curl in my hair, but I'm also able to get bigger chunks when I'm drying my hair. So like overall, the entire experience just goes so much faster. And I like, oh my God, it is literally night and day. And I highly recommend, okay, if you are someone, you have, again, medium to long hair, and you find that this one can just be a little bit tricky, it's hard to fit your hair on there, whatever, oh my God, try it. It is such a game changer. All right, so next up, I want to talk to you guys about a highlight. This is new from Catrice. I think that I've talked about this roughly 17 times, and it is absolutely stunning. This is their More Than a Glow highlighter, and I have destroyed it, guys. I use this like every single day, and this is in the shade 020 Supreme Rose Beam, and it is gorgeous. Like the texture, the mill, everything about this, the way that it just presses into your skin is so stunning. And the highlight itself is actually surprisingly workable. You can sheer it out if you want more of just like a nice little flush across the cheek, just like a little, ooh, like a little glaze, if you will. But you can also, of course, build it up and get a really beautiful, oh my God, just look at that. Oh, it's like the perfect texture and consistency of what I would call like a wet highlight. But again, because you can work with it and dull it down or bring it more forward, you really get to even play around with that end of it as well. Like how pronounced you really want it to be on your cheek. This is one of those highlights for me that I'm so impressed with, because if you didn't know that it was from the drugstore, like you wouldn't be able to guess looking at it, because the texture, the feel, the mill, everything about this just screams high-end, expensive, luxurious, and it's definitely not, okay? It's definitely drugstore, which makes me love it that much more, so I had to give it a shout out because it's so gorgeous. And because, you know, it's like literally the only highlight I've been using, but who's counting? All right, so next up, we're gonna talk about a palette. This is one I have talked about before, but this is the Kaleidos Shasimi City palette, and I love this so much. I actually talked about it on accident in my year-end favorites drugstore from 2020, which I'll link that one and the high-end up in the cards if you want to check them out. But yeah, this definitely isn't drugstore, and I totally screwed that up. I'm sorry, which I told you guys in the comments. But this palette is so freaking stunning, you guys. I have been wearing it every single day. I love taking this shade right here and just putting it all over the lid. It's gorgeous. You can deepen up with this one if you want, or you can just run like a little bit of these two shades through the crease. You can throw a sparkle on. And I think for me, it's just been like the easiest palette because everything about it screams out the door. Like whether it's, again, all over the lid, if it's a little through the crease, you want to add a sparkle, you don't. Like it doesn't matter because everything in here is the perfect depth. It's the perfect undertone. Like everything, it just works so well that it's effortless. You can be on a phone call, you can be in a hurry. And for me, it's just been the perfect option because of that. Cause like all of February, I've been so freaking busy and I love this. So I had to give it a shout out. I know I just literally just talked about it, but this palette is so freaking great that I had to talk about it again. All right, so next up, you know how I just said that this one from Kaleidos was like the last, you know, couple of weeks? Well, the first couple of weeks of February, I gotta give it up to the Faded Clementine because this palette is so great, you guys. Like the quality of the shades, they work so well together. And there's something about this color story that I was just really, like I was going through it with it because I love the gold. I love the combination of like that orange with the pink. And it's a lot of the same thing that I said with the Kaleidos as it is with this one. Like the quality of it is there. And I love the color choice. I love that, you know, I can pair like this purpley pink situation with the orange, like complement really well. You can wear one or the other. You can pop a gold shimmer. You can put on this really, oh my God, like the, oh my God, it feels so good. These, what is this? More of like a deep kind of berry copper shade. Like everything in here just pairs so gorgeous together. You could quite literally choose colors at random and you would still create a gorgeous eye look because they all blend together. And just like the color story melds so perfectly that it's such an easy, again, go-to palette. If you love shades like this, I highly recommend it. All right, now next up, we're gonna talk about one that I know I have mentioned in literally every single application video, but I don't know if it's ever been in an actual favorite. So I'm gonna keep it brief just because, again, I don't know if I've talked about it, but I wanna give a little head nod to the Fenty Pro Matte Foundation Powder. I use this in the shade 150. And this powder, like the texture, the mill, the feel, everything about it is so freaking great. Like the texture of it is just so refined on my skin. But because of that, for me personally, I do prefer this as an actual like setting foundation powder where I go over a liquid foundation and, you know, I set down my face versus using it by itself. myself as an actual like full coverage foundation. And that's just because for me personally, I do need a lot more coverage. Like I have redness, I have hyperpigmentation, I have pores, crevasses. I got a lot going on this face. And I feel like because this is so finely milled and it has such a great texture to it that works again really well if you're trying to set your face or, you know, really work with it as a powder, it really lends well. But trying to get it to build up, it does take a little bit longer. You have to really kind of thickly cake it on. You have to cake it on a little bit thick. There we go. If you're trying to like build this, you know, coverage by itself with just this, at least in my experience. So for me, again, I do really love it, but I prefer it as just a setting powder, like to set my whole face. And for that, it is amazing. I love to just fluff it on with a brush, just poop, 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 and it sets perfectly. It's nice. It's refined. It presses into my skin, and bitch, it is gorgeous. All right, so next up, I just got done reapplying this because I didn't realize I had quite literally talked all of it off, but this is the Charlotte Tilbury, I think it's called their Hyaluronic Happy Kiss Lipstick or something like that. And this is in the shade Happy Berry. And you guys, this is such a great product. If you're someone like me and you are always looking for that in-between consistency, like you want it to have maybe, you know, the slip and feel of a balm, you want it to have a little bit of gloss, but not too much, but you also want it to have the opacity of a lipstick, this is that queen, okay? I want this in like a perfect nude brown. Actually, you know what? I take that back. I want it in every nude brown shade because it is so great. Like I would wear this every single day. It wears so easily. Like the application of it is great. And I love the fact too, that just like I was actually saying with the highlighter from Catrice, this is one of those products that you really can wear however you want to wear it. Like if you want to just, you know, take a little bit, do some of this and have it be more of a light flush because of the texture, because it has more of that balm texture to it, you can do that. If you want to go in and apply it full on like I did, you can do that. It works great with lip liners. It works great with literally whatever capacity you want to use it as. And I just think that the formula of this is so nice and so luxurious feeling, especially during the winter when like everything is all dried out and just like, ugh. For me, this is the time when I need this, okay? I need this situation to be nice and cushy and squishy on my lips at a time when they're just kind of feeling a little bit busted and crusted, and I'm just obsessed. So I wanted to mention that. And then I also wanted to give a huge shout out. Guys, I loved this color way more than I thought I would. This is also from M Cosmetics, and this is their Faded Clementine Lip Cushion, which again, very similar to the one that I'm talking about from Charlotte Tilbury. This one has that same like nice kind of lip balmy slip to it. It has a little bit of shine, but this one, I mean, as you can tell, it is orange, which is quite the difference. I would say it's about half as opaque as the one from Charlotte Tilbury is, and they do have this in a ton of colors on their website, so I'll make sure it's linked down below. Just in case maybe, you know, you love like the concept of it, maybe you like the look of it, whatever, but maybe orange isn't your color, which I will admit, it wasn't mine either until I mixed it, which I'll talk about it in a second. But yeah, I'll leave it linked down below if you want to check it out. Regardless of what color you find, the texture and the formula of all of them is top-notch, highly recommend. But with this one, I'm actually going to combine it and talk about it alongside another favorite, one that I literally have not stopped talking about for the last maybe month and a half, 2 months, and that would be the Essence Stay 8-Hour Lip Liner, and this is in the shade Because Duh, which I think as of right now, this might be sold out on Ulta, I'm not sure, but I'll still leave it linked down below. They've got like 8 different shades, something like that. Please, Essence, by the way, come out with more. These are amazing. Like I love them. The texture, the staying power, the creaminess, everything about them is perfect, okay? Just know that. But mixing these two shades together, this one up here, again, the pinky shade, that is Because Duh. And it's more of like a deep-toned mauve-y pink. And I know on my hand, obviously, they're not gonna simulate the same as they would on my lips. But the thing that I loved about this and the combination is exactly what I loved about the little duo here from M Cosmetics that I was talking about, because it's that same kind of mixture between the pink and the gold hues and like having that pop of orange in there. So if you're someone that you enjoy this color story, but you're not sure about the lip, I felt the exact same way, okay? I was very, very hesitant, but I fell in love with this combo right here. And actually, you know what? I have worn this combo, like the two of these together, so much in the last 2 weeks that I had to pull it out of my jacket pocket because I carried them with me every single day, everywhere that I went. It was just all that I wanted to wear because it's the perfect balance of, you know, having a little bit of a lip line, not too much. The orange softens it, but you still get that color, that mixture, that depth, and everything about it is great. So I just highly, highly recommend. All right, so the last thing that I want to touch on, I'm sorry, the last thing that I need to touch on, you guys, I'm gonna put my leg down for this. I'm sitting here all like crisscross applesauce. I got my legs all over the place, but we need to talk about this freaking e.l.f. What is this? This is their Enhancing Lash and Brow Serum. Y'all, this stuff is so freaking amazing. Like I am actually shocked at how much I love this. And y'all know, okay, I got some piddly ass little eyelashes. I have next to no brow hairs, okay? Like I have had to grow and cultivate. I have had to farm what brow hairs I have. And this serum is unbelievably good. I noticed a difference in like 3 weeks. Like it just, I noticed that my lashes were longer and they were more hoo-hoo, like that, what, I'm sorry, hoo-hoo, what is that? I don't know. But they were just so much more luxury, again with this noise that absolutely doesn't describe anything. I'm so sorry. I guess I'm really hoping that like my interpretive lash dance will just really, really help the situation. No? Okay. But guys, seriously, this lash serum is so good. I tried this on my eyebrows. I tried it on my eyelashes. It didn't agitate anything. Like it, I never had any issues. Cause you know how some brow serums, like they're a little bit sketchy. And this one is, and for the price, I'm not gonna lie. Okay. I love e.l.f. and I think that so much of what they make is amazing, but an $8 lash serum had me a little bit on edge, you know what I'm saying? Like, I was a little bit curious what would be in there. Also, and just as a final note here, I want to mention, this is not my first bottle, okay? I like this enough that I repurchased a second bottle of it because it's just that good. I've been using it now for, what, like 2-ish months? Maybe even, actually, you know what? It might be closer to 3 months now. Whenever they launched it, I picked it up right after that. And I have just been obsessed. Again, 2 bottles in, I like it. I've had no issues. And I really think that you should check it out. If you're trying to grow your stuff, if you're trying to just, you know, grow it out up here, highly recommend. But all right, you guys, that is it. Those are all my favorites for the month of February. I hope that this video was helpful. Do I have lipstick on my teeth? Okay, sorry. Anyways, I get a little bit distracted because, I mean, like, what if I had it on my teeth this whole video? You guys, when I tell you, I would scream. Okay, I would scream. But anyways, nonetheless, that is the end of my video. Guys, I hope that this was helpful to you. A couple of things. Make sure that you leave me all of your favorites down below, whether they are favorites that are current, things you've just been loving, maybe you pulled them out of your collection, whatever. I just, of course, want to hear from you, and I want to know what's good, you guys. I want to know what's good. If you got the line on something that I should know about, hello, hook me up, okay? I'm not just an island floating around out here by myself. I need to know what's good too, so make sure you drop that down below. And I also didn't mention, like, I don't know what happened to me, but I didn't mention at the start of this and like go through my spiel. So make sure you subscribe, turn on your post notifications. If you're new here, I do put up 3 new videos a week, typically Monday, Wednesday, Friday, right around like 7:30-ish a.m. my time here in good old Northern Michigan. Of course, I'm a Northern Michigander, so we got those early morning uploads. And also too, please make sure that you go follow me over on Instagram. I would really appreciate it. I am currently trying to hit 10,000 followers over there. Not only am I trying to hit that, like obviously, yes, that's my goal, but I do put up a ton of content over there. I'm always hanging out in the Insta stories. If you want the behind the scenes, you want to see unboxing, see what's coming next to the channel, you want to go for walks, polls, and just really get to have like that one-on-one connection, that's definitely the place to do it. In addition to that, I also upload to the feed a ton. So we've got like plus size fashion, we have makeup content, testing new makeup, testing really whatever comes in like throughout the week that I can't get here fast enough, I always put it up over there. That way you guys kind of know what's going on as quickly as possible. Just make sure you're following me over there is the moral of the story. Everything will be linked down below. And of course too, along with that, y'all, I just want to say a huge thank you one more time to Billy. Thank you so much, Billy, for partnering with me on this video. It was absolutely awesome. I love what you guys stand for, and I hope that you guys take a second. Like I said before, their site will be linked down below. I highly encourage you to check it out. Give them a round of applause too. While we're at it, y'all, just give it up to them in the comments. Oh, and also too, just really quick, and you're probably like, Paige, why won't you stop talking? And I just can't. Okay, some things just keep, they just keep on a rolling. But I have to mention this, okay, this top, because I know I'm going to get questions. This is actually a Fabletics lit combo that I picked up from their site, and it is not sponsored. I don't work with Fabletics yet. Okay, I'm still manifesting it. I'm manifesting it into the universe. But this combo I got from their site, it's from their most recent collab. And this yellow, first of all, okay, I can't wear yellow. I look all kinds of awful in yellow, but this looks gorgeous. Okay, I love it. It works with my skin tone. And the actual material is like, it is the softest. I don't even know how to describe it. It's just like the softest thing I've ever touched. Okay, number one, it's light, it's airy, it feels so luxurious. And then I paired it with this asymmetrical sports bra thing. Like it has one strap over here, two over here. It's just, oh my, everything about this is so cute. So I'll have the outfit linked, but I'll also have my link if you want to join Fabletics. I'll have that down below as well. And I highly recommend it, y'all. I am obsessed, okay? We all know I love Fabletics at this point, but like, bitch. Are you kidding me? Like, are you actually kidding? This is my heart and soul you're looking at. Like, but you guys, that is it for real this time. Thank you all so much for watching. Please don't forget to have an amazing day, night, weekend, whatever it is when you're watching this, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Well, hello, beautiful people. Welcome back. Welcome to what has to be the fastest month in all of history. Does it? Is it the fastest month in all of history, Paige? Okay. Well, hello, beautiful people. Welcome back. Guys, welcome to what has to be the fastest month in all of history. Solid recovery history. Okay, so let me just give you like the full scope of what's happening and how cute it is, okay? Because this freaking outfit, like it actually slays my whole existence, okay? Get the hair up out of the way and just like maybe pull this over. Like, do you see? Do you see? Do you see what I see? I just can't even stand it. I can't. I look like I'm teaching aerobics in the 80s right now. Oh my God, what a day to be alive, especially for me, for my heart and soul, bitch. That is where I belong. But this outfit, like, oh my, in this yellow, guys, I can't wear yellow. I don't think you understand. You don't understand the significance of what's happening here because it is gorgeous. I'm just embracing it, y'all. I'm full on Big Bird mode right now, and I'm ba 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 ba. I'm loving it. Speaking of, where the fuck is my Diet Coke? I'm perched. I'm sorry, is that you, Big Bird? Hi. Oh my God, do you guys remember that movie with Big Bird? It was literally called, I think, Catch That Bird. Was that what that was called? Hold on. I'm just gonna check it out real quick. Follow That Bird. It's called Follow That Bird, okay? Circa 1985, Sesame Street. Follow That Bird. Oh, chef's kiss, beautiful.